are talking about colleges closing down. Other hand, we are talking about online, growing of the ladder. That day, when the director of the institute asked me a question, Dr. Sarungay, when few of the engineering and management institutes are closing down, why are you propagating online so much? Let these colleges go on. The simple question I asked him in turn was, if Big Bazaar or Shoppers Stop is going vacant, should I be asked the Snapdeal, Amazon and Flipkart to close down because the brick and mortar models are going empty? The survival of fitness, the need of hour. Just to give a small example, my faculty, Professor Mankekar, who taught me way back in 1989 in finance, to get such a faculty is very, very difficult. The person, I should not talk about his wealth, but the so-called Warren Buffett of Indian stock market. Maybe not less than $2 billion, right? What was the learning? Fantastic. Even though I was an HR student, my heart beats for finance. That was the quality of education. Now, if that faculty is available to webcast his lecture across the country to somebody in Bhopal or Gaya or Solapur, Kolhapur, where the quality education is not possible, and if these faculties are available online, what will happen? That's what we are talking about online. So, way back in 2010, in 1998, originally when I was in the US and I saw the penetration of online education in the US, I said, yes, we can do something in India. So in 2010, when Jagogi started in India, meant only for working professional in the industry. Because being an HR head, every year I used to have a problem. Every profession wants to become the CEO of a company or managing director of a company. Now to become that, you need to have multifunctional knowledge. Operation guy doesn't understand finance. Finance guy doesn't understand marketing. And now to have all vertical knowledge, they need to learn. And old days, people are not MBA. Today kids are lucky enough that they are getting their parents their money and they can get MBA education immediately after college. I had to work for 6 years after my graduation, earn money, then go down to MBA institute and study MBA. So earlier days we had a responsibility to educate our siblings and then grow. So when in the industry I saw, being an HR head, that the population is stagnating, is not able to grow up because of not having that management education, we started online and we got wonderful results. Only one issue we had, with due respect to all the academic faculties, in management education per se, you need to have corporate experience, a master. Because when you educate management, and if you have not worked in the corporate world, it becomes little difficult. Because if you're not acquired or merged entities, you cannot talk about under theory. You're not handled strike, lockout, layoff, you cannot teach from the theory. So while employing the faculties, I had to, I'm sorry, I'm honest, replace 80% of the faculties. And I had to get all corporate faculty with industrial experience to teach you working professions, and then only they can. Now, whether useful, whether effective, one who does full-time MBA is today also unemployed. The thousands of students doing full-time MBA are unemployed because you sit in the class and you don't study. Whereas a guy who is working in the industry, a lady who is balancing between the professional, personal and the social life, working 12, 13, 14 hours, getting online education, sitting at home, online lectures on Saturday, Sunday, comfortably, take a pause, didn't understand, go twice, thrice, four times to study the same topic. Wonderful faculty level people who have corporate experience and it becomes successful. So within 5 years, 60,000 students, all working professions, no marketing, no advertisement, zero, only word of mouth. And today we got a demand from IT professions. Dr. Sarungay, please launch MS in IT, MS in computer science, MS in project management, and we are just launching. Then the second era is coming now. When we welcome these foreign education institutions to come down here, you look at the online models in the US, and I hope you must have studied. Phoenix, $2 billion. So with 67 rupees to dollar, 13,400 crore. Laureate, 13,000 crore. Linda.com, I got acquired by LinkedIn recently, $1.5 billion, around 11,000 crore. Where are we then? What are we operating in? we thought of, why not we go down to US and we acquire a US university? If they can acquire us, why we can't acquire? And luckily, I am happy to say that in the next 4-5 months, we should be successful by April or so to acquire an online US university and offer MS program. Because the, I just take 2-3 minutes, is it okay? Okay. In India, if Narasimha Rao and Bellingers and so on institutions are offering full-time India 10 lakh rupees, online is available at 60,000 rupees, 5% of the fee. In US, the classroom in India is $20,000, online is $14,000, 70% of the fee. What is the difference? The perception. In US they say, hey, I am benefiting you by sitting at home and studying. In India they say, hey, online there is no cost, give me free. That's the reason. Right? But I think the days are not far off when we will be in the same race, and I hope we will set a new example to start with to acquire a US online university, and then we'll talk about $1 billion. Thank you very much.